How's it going, everybody? Peter here, and welcome to my latest Let's Play of Train Simulator Classic. Today, folks, we're going to be using the Yellowhead Pass route, and we're going to be taking an intermodal train all the way to Jasper. And we are using a Tier 4 GEVO, but that is the Heritage livery, and that one is 3115. I'm just going to extend the view. I'm just going to set up the headlights and make sure we've got everything turned on. So I'm going to back up a wee bit just to show you the train a bit better. Just turn on the dish lights and the headlights and stuff. We'll turn on the onboard lights before we get moving. So without further ado, folks, this will be a 2-hour run, and I've just edited the default scenario just for the benefit of this pack. So without further ado, let's get started. By the way, folks, this reskin pack is freeware, and I will be covering the others around November and December, so stay tuned for those, as this is a pack of four based on the four Heritage liveries that are on the GE Tier 4 GEVO, and this one is 3115 in the BC Rail livery, or the British Columbia Rail livery, and it does look rather nice. So anyway, folks, now we're clear of the crossing, let's get this speed up. So bring us up to speed now, just so we're not any later than we are, as this is just a modified default scenario. And I didn't copy this, but I cloned it, and I just changed the trains around. So we will see the other trains as NPCs as we pass them. So let's open up the power then, folks, and let's bring this up to speed then. Okay, folks, as we do have the space for now, let's open up the power to notch 8, that is 900% on this setup, and let's get this train up to speed of up to 65 miles an hour. And we do have some more crossings, so I will try to do the correct horn sequence if I can. so I do hope you will enjoy this ride. And I quite like this route, to be honest with you folks. We do have another crossing coming up, folks, so I'm just going to use a wee bit of braking just to bring our speed down just in time before the new speed limit comes on. But this is career mode, and I've just edited a default scenario, and I do have career score mode turned off, so it's not really a deal breaker. If I had the career mode scoring turned on, I would probably, I don't know, plan more ahead, but I decided to have fun. And by the way, folks, just going up to another crossing. Okay, that's another one that comes in the park. That is Illinois Central 3008, and I did a review of the model back in June, so it is quite a familiar one to me, and I do like that one. And I do have another Heritage Canadian National in scale model that will be reviewed later this year, although I'm not saying which one it is. I'll let you guess, and no prizes for guessing correct, folks, although I won't unveil it until the review, and that will be just before Christmas this year of 2023. So, how are you all keeping today? I hope all of you are having a wonderful day or a wonderful weekend or whenever you are watching this video. And by all means, please do let me know your thoughts and your feedback on these Let's Plays that I do, as I do read and respond to all comments. This one, folks, will be about 2 hours or just under, as that's what it says on the default scenario. But I've not played the original, I just modified this one just so that I can cover these Tier 4 GEVOs on a proper Canadian National route. And this Yellowhead Pass is a perfect fitment, although I will use some of the US American routes to cover the other three liveries. Of which, by the way, folks, those scenarios will be created by me. And I'm just doing a casual Let's Play with this one, as I'm just getting used to this route as well. Although I did pick this one up back in the spring sale. I've only just got round to releasing the Let's Plays of it, as I did have quite a big schedule. But we're here now, and I did manage to get this one fitted in on this year's schedule. And I will do more of this in 2024 as well. So there'll be plenty of North American and Canadian Let's Plays in terms of Train Simulator Classic to come well into 2024 as well. So I'm looking forward to those. Okay, so we've got enough power just to keep the momentum going as we're going uphill. However, we do have an upcoming speed limit of 45 miles an hour, so it's best that we should start notching down now and just coast, as then we should lose enough speed to be under the 45 miles an hour limit once we reach the new enforced speed limit, all being well. So if not, I will do a wee bit of braking just to bring our speed down if necessary, but hopefully we should be under 45 miles an hour by the time we reach the new speed limit. Okay, folks, we've lost a bit too much speed there, so I'm just putting it onto notch 3 just to gradually build our speed up. So if we go a bit too fast as we reach 45, I will idle the throttle, or I'll come down to notch 2 just to keep within the friendly side of 45 miles an hour. Okay folks, that should keep the speed nice and level as we've just entered the speed zone of 35 miles an hour. So I just wanted to use enough power to keep the momentum going without going too fast for the speed limit. And to be quite frankly honest folks, I really am enjoying this one and I hope you are too. Obviously, this is a very early morning start, as I usually do late mornings, early days, well, early afternoons, in terms of my scenarios, so it's nice to do an early morning run as well, and I really do like this route, folks. Okay, we're just reaching the very tip of the limit of the speed limit, so we'll have to keep an eye on the speed now, and I think we will have to notch down just to stay on the good side of 35 miles an hour. And once we drop a wee bit of speed, I will put the power back on to notch 2. Yes, folks, this route does kind of remind me of the Mirai's Pass in some aspects, especially this part, as we go under this tunnel thing. So, I actually do quite like this route, and I do like all the forests and stuff. And I'm assuming this scenario would be based in the spring, as in winter, this would all be covered in snow and stuff. But I would at some point do a winter scenario on this route, just to show all the seasons and stuff, you know. Okay, folks, I do hope you are enjoying this one. And I certainly am enjoying this Let's Play. And just been focusing on the going to the destination. And I was just thinking, there is some stations on this route as well. And obviously, it would be via rail that would work the services on this. So I just have one question. Would anyone know if Amtrak do cross-border services that would serve this route? As I was planning on making a scenario based on that, if they do in the real world. But if not, it doesn't matter. I will make something else with possibly a Canadian F40PH or something. But what's available in the reskins and stuff, you know. But that will be for another Let's Play in the future. But it is on the cards, as I would like to do a passenger scenario on this route at some point in the future. As I really do like this one. So I was just wondering, if they do, that'd be grand. But if not, I will think of something. So please do let me know in the comment section below. And I do appreciate any advice on this in the future. And thank you in advance. As I was saying there, thank you in advance. I wasn't sure if the siren cut there because it did stutter a bit, as it does that when loading the NPC trains at times. So I was just wondering. Anyways, that will be for a future planned Let's Play, once I've done some recon on the passenger services that would run through this route. Okay folks, we're now in the 50 miles an hour zone, so let's open up the power and let's build up our speed then. I have to say one thing folks, I really do like the signs on this locomotive and I'm a big fan of the GE Tier 4 GEVOs, and I do have about 8 N-scale models of those from scale trains, and I do have some more reviews to come in November and December of other models I've not covered before, so that will be something to look forward to. By the way folks, I'm going to go up to Knot 6, as that's more than enough to build our speed up gradually without the risk of breaking the coupler, as these are much more powerful than the SD40-2Ws that come with this route by default. So I've got a DPU locomotive on the back, but I'm trying to control these trains properly if I can. will notch down to notch 4, as that should be enough to keep the momentum going. If not, I'll just come back down to 3, as we are slightly over speed and we are almost on level ground, and we will be going downhill slightly as we get closer to the other tracks, and we will see more NPC trains very soon. In fact, what I'm going to do, I'll bring it down to notch 2, as that should be enough to bring the speed down. But for whatever reason, the speed is not decreasing, as I try not to idle if I can help it. So I'll bring it down to notch 1, and then I will build it up gradually again, just to keep the momentum going. So folks, what do you think to this route? What do you like about it? What do you think could be better? Please do let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. books. That was just too good to pass up, so I just thought I'd take advantage of that position and do a very nice, cool looking thumbnail with the river and the mountains and all that in the background, as it really does look cool. So I might use that one for this let's play, but I'll just use the close up version for the benefit of this train. But anyways, we are still in a 50 miles an hour zone and we will be able to go faster soon as we enter the 55 miles an hour speed limit. And fingers crossed, I'm hoping that all traffic will be working this time around. So fingers crossed for that. Okay folks, I just thought we'd just go to knot 3 and build our speed up gradually, as we've only got about 5 miles leeway just to go faster, so there's no point in me going any higher than knot 3 just to build our speed up gradually, just in case I need to slow down again if there is any more lower speed limits coming up, so just factoring that in as well. But I really do like this route, folks. It's just very nicely detailed. I love the landscape. I love the fact that you can drive alongside the river in a train. That really is cool. And I'm so glad I got this route, and to be quite frankly honest, I like this route better than the Peace River Bridge route. So I do like this one better, and it is more functional in terms of NPC trains as well. So at least we can run NPC trains alongside the player train on this route, unlike the other one I have. So this one is much better in my opinion. Anyway folks, just coming up to our first railroad crossing in a while, so better not forget to turn on the bell very soon and do the horn sequencer for the railroad crossing. Thank you. Okay, folks, I'm so pleased that NPC train is working without issues this time around, and I really am thankful for that. It's just a shame that the headlights don't work on the NPC trains for whatever reason, of which is beknown to the scripts, I'm assuming. Anyway, folks, just coming up to this 45 miles an hour speed zone, so I just want to make sure we're slowing down enough so that we are in within the 45 by the time it comes in. But we're slightly over speed, but no bother, I'm not too fussed, folks, and I really am enjoying this myself on this one, and I hope you are enjoying this cab view of the route as well in this let's play. And we've got about just under 17 miles, correction, just under 16 miles to go before we reach Yellowhead East South track, as I'm assuming we will be finishing off in the train yard there, so that should be interesting. Okay, folks, we're just coming up to a 40 miles an hour speed limit, and fingers crossed, we should be just within the speed limit as we enter it. And I do hope there is a fix or an unofficial patch for the headlights on the Tier 4 GEVOs, as I would like to see the headlights function on the NPC controlled GE Tier 4 GEVOs, as they do work fine on these EMD SD40-2Ws that comes with the route. So I've just left that one in and tweaked it just to modernise it a bit by removing all the cabooses from the consists when necessary. And in truth, folks, I really am enjoying this let's play, but it would be nice if there is a patch available that will fix the headlight issue, as I would like them to function on the NPC controlled Tier 4 GEVOs. Anyway, folks, we've got about just 11 and a half miles to go, and I think that will be the finishing point for this scenario and, of course, this let's play. Okay, folks, we're just coming into a 40 miles an hour zone, and we've got just under 7 miles to go before we reach the Yellowhead E-South track. That will be our final checkpoint before we are due to terminate at the Yellowhead train yard, as that is the limit of this route, folks. But all in all, I really have enjoyed this one, and I hope you have enjoyed the trip on this Let's Play too. And as always, folks, I do welcome your comments as well as your feedback in the comment section, as it does help me improve where I can do better. But I always welcome positive feedback as well, so positive and constructive comments will always be welcome on the channel. Thank you. Okay, folks, we've just got under 1.5 miles to go before we reach our final checkpoint on this route. And we've just entered the 40 miles an hour zone without the need for me to idle the power. So that's grand. So we are going slightly uphill, so that allows us to keep the momentum going without the need to reduce power too much. So I'm happy with that. And folks, if you are still watching this video through to the end, I do appreciate your support, and I'm glad to know that you are enjoying my Let's Plays. And to be honest with you folks, I do enjoy making these, and I do have more to come for the rest of this year and well into 2024 as well. So there'll be plenty of content. Model train reviews every Saturday, UK time 11 a.m. and 3 times a week I do Let's Plays of various transport simulation video games on this channel. So that's how it is for 2023, folks, for the remainder of this year anyways. I may implement a new schedule from February 2024, so I will try to keep the model train reviews coming every week in 2024, but that will be up to the end of January, folks, and it may well change after that. But anyway, folks, we're just coming up to our checkpoint, and I'm just making sure that I have got the horn sequence correct here. As you know, I'm totally new to this route, and I'm just learning on the go, and I really do enjoy doing these Let's Plays, folks. And I do have many more planned to come. So folks, if you do have any requests on any particular locomotives you want me to cover in a future Let's Play, please do feel free to leave me a comment in the comment section below and let me know what trains you'd like me to cover in future Let's Plays. Okay folks, we will be going to Jasper. That will be our terminal point, as that is the end of the route, and that will be where this Let's Play will finish. And that's just under 18 miles to go. Okay, folks. I think we will be able to do a nice speed run all the way to Jasper, as we are due to enter the 65 miles an hour speed zone. So once we are clear of this 45 miles an hour speed restriction, we can then give these GE Tier 4 GEVOs a good thrashing all the way to Jasper. So that should test the power and the speed of these diesel locomotives. So we should be able to reach 65 miles an hour, no problem at all. Okay, folks, without further ado, let's open up the power. Okay, folks, that was quite a nice speed run there, and good opportunity to give these locomotives a good stretch on this part of the route. However, we are coming up to the 50 miles an hour zone, folks, so we better start using the brakes and bringing our trains down to a more manageable level. Okay, that should be slow enough for the upcoming speed limit of 50 miles an hour. And I really am enjoying this one, folks. We've only got 11 miles to go before we reach our final checkpoint at Jasper Yard Track 1 East. So that will be the end point for this Let's Play and, of course, this scenario. Okay, folks, we're just coming up to the 50 miles an hour speed zone, and to be quite frank, guys, I really have enjoyed doing this let's play. I really do love the landscape, the mountains, the scenery, and to be quite frankly honest, this is my favourite Canadian route of all three. And that's just my personal preference on this one, folks. So I will very likely cover this one in the future, in many more let's plays to come in the future as well. And I will do the Peace River Bridge a couple of more times, and then I will be very much done with that, and I'll just use the built-in scenarios that come with that. But other than that, folks, it will be mostly this route that I will cover Canadian trains on, and I would like to make a couple of passenger scenarios for this one, so that should be interesting. But anyway, folks, we just got just under 6 miles to go before we reach our final destination of Jasper Yard, as that will be our finishing point for this scenario and of course this let's play. And I've really enjoyed this one. I know it's a long one, but I do enjoy these longer ones, and I find these quite relaxing to do. Okay, folks, we are now in the 50 miles an hour speed zone, so let's open up the par to notch 5. That should be enough to pick up speed, but not too fast, and I will have to ease off as we get closer towards 50 miles an hour, and I will try to find the right notch to use just to keep the momentum going so we do not lose too much speed. Okay, folks, we're just coming into Jasper Yard, and that will be very much the end of this Let's Play and this scenario. And I do hope you enjoyed this one, as I certainly have. And if you stayed with me through to the end of this video, a big thank you for your support, and thank you for watching all the way through. Okay, folks, I just want to say a big thank you for watching all the way through. And that concludes this Let's Play of Train Simulator Classic with the Yellowhead Pass route and with this heritage liveried GE Tier 4 GEVO ET44AC. And as I'd like to say to you, take care of yourselves and each other. All the best, God bless, thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.